I want to talk today a little bit about facilitative leadership. That is an approach to leadership or organizational management that puts an emphasis on how the person at the top helps everybody else do their job rather than just sending out dictates or worrying about how they do their job, only their own job. So facilitative leadership's a departure from some of the traditional thinking about a leader. Most people think a leader's strong, decisive, makes definitive judgments, sends the messages down the chain of command, telling people what to do. I'm not convinced that that's a great model of leadership. So I want to talk about an alternative, facilitative leadership. I want to talk about what facilitative leaders have in their head, what they're thinking about. I want to talk about what facilitative leaders do, especially that differentiates them from more traditional leader as person in charge. And then I want to talk a little bit about how facilitative leaders can and should judge their own performance, okay? So what's in their head of someone who thinks of themselves as a facilitative leader? Well, in my view, the single most important thing that a facilitative leader should be thinking about is how to unleash the capacity in their organization so that everything can get done effectively. How to build the capacity of the people that work for them. How to build the organization's capacity to improve, to learn from its experience. Now, that means that a facilitative leader has to both be ready to provide leadership and direction and vision and work with the board of directors, but also has to be attentive to what does it mean to enhance the capacity of the people who work for her or for him to get the job done. Now, I don't think that means a facilitative leader never lays out a direction or priorities, but I would argue that a facilitative leader has to be as focused on how do you remove the obstacles to the people that are working for you so that they can do what needs to be done. It's not their problem, it's your problem as a facilitative leader to remove obstacles to enhance capabilities.
Do you think, though, that when they're working this way, that they might feel like they appear weak or, you know, to not have that kind of directive capacity and authority?
It's possible. Again, I think I'd rather think of a facilitative leader as someone who combines some measure of authority, some stature as a visionary and as an effective manager and as a leader with this focus on building organizational capacity, particularly thinking about the problems that are going to come up for the people that work for you and how you can clear those out of the way or build their ability to overcome them. So I don't want to lay these out as exclusive, but I would argue that a facilitative leader is at least as concerned about organizational capacity as they are about direction and leadership. And it's possible someone can say, you mean you're worried about the people that work for you? You're weak. I don't buy that. I think that we're seeing more and more, especially in very spread out or far-flung or flat organizations where layers of administration are being removed, that you've got to count on the people in your organization to be able to surface problems and solve them and not wait for directives from above. And for that to happen, the facilitative leader has to anticipate those things and build the capacity of their people to handle obstacles. Now, that's what they should be thinking about. In terms of the things they do, I would emphasize three kinds of things. The first is that I think facilitative leaders have to model a way of working with folks that they want everyone else to model when they deal with the people who report to them. In other words, if I'm not ready to do what I want everybody else to do, then I don't think I can be a facilitative leader. So I want to be facilitative in a way that instructs, that models for the people that work for me, what does it mean to anticipate the problems your people are going to encounter, to build their capacity to deal with them, to share that concern that they might have. So modeling facilitative behavior is key to being a facilitative leader. I also think that it's important for facilitative leaders to reward effective behavior, so that if I want to build my organization's capacity to do things and I spot someone doing a really good job and I want to enhance their ability to keep doing that, I need to say, that's a really good thing you're doing. Let me try to reward you with a promotion, with a raise, whatever it is. Mm-hmm. My sense is that modeling what I mean by facilitative behavior needs to be coupled with rewarding facilitative behavior and effective facilitative behavior when you see it. I also think that it's not enough to tell people to be facilitative. You have to coach them. Now, I know that not everybody's cut out to be a coach. I know that coaching means not just giving orders, but anticipating the problems people might have, fulfilling their obligations, and giving them feedback along the way and giving them instruction as needed to be able to do what you're saying so that the next time they'll be able to do it on their own. So I see a facilitative leader as a good coach. Mm-hmm. I see a facilitative leader as someone who's concerned about building capacity so that ultimately they might even put themselves out of business. Mm-hmm. Again, I know that that's a little different from how traditional discussions of leadership in organizations go.
It sounds good. It sounds like it would be good if you have really good people you work with to model and to reward and to coach. But what if something goes wrong? How does a facilitative leader deal with that?
Yeah, I think the last thing I can raise in this short segment is that facilitative leaders need to measure their success by the success of the people that work for them, which means that if you've given someone a responsibility, you've tried to coach them, you've tried to model how you think they can help other people work, and it's not working, you have to step in. So part of gauging your success as a facilitative leader isn't just did you build organizational capacity, is did the results that needed to get done. And if there's some chance that that's not working, then the facilitative leader has to step in and find some workaround or some alternative to make sure things happen. So I would think that facilitative leaders would gauge their success both in terms of the capacity that they build in their organization over time and in terms of the results that the organization gets.